Lonnie, this is our first conversation since your primary victory. Congratulations on that. Now we know who your challenger is, Malia Cohen. We had her on the show last week. Considering the electorate here in California, you're going to need Democrats to vote for you in November. How are you going to get them to do that?
Well, we're going to need people from all political backgrounds, Nikki, to support our campaign. And the reality is the center of my campaign, the center of my candidacy for controller is about bringing transparency and accountability to our state spending. I have said that from day one. I am focused on how we get Californians more information about how our state is spending money so that we don't have a repeat of that $20 billion unemployment insurance fiasco where money was sent to fraudsters in China and Russia and people in prison, where we don't have a lack of accountability around all the money we spend on public education in this state. I believe people in California deserve the best when it comes to information about how this state is spending money. And my campaign is going to be all about that. And I believe that when voters hear that message, and when they hear about my plans to bring specific transparency and accountability to state spending, they're going to be supportive of me, whether they're Democrats or independents or Republicans. So I look forward to the campaign ahead and to making that abundantly clear.
So there's been a lot of excitement surrounding your race, because as we like to point out here in California, as journalists, as political journalists, a Republican has not won statewide since 2006. And any headline, any news story about you has brought up that fact. And maybe you are the person that could do that. No pressure. But what do you say to the critics that call your campaign fleeting? And, you know, in the primary election, there were other Democrats that split the vote. But now that it's head to head, a D versus an R, you're going to have an uphill battle.
Well, listen, political prognostication is a whole business. And I understand people are going to do what they need to do to talk about what they think is going to happen. I'm focused on winning the vote of every single Californian, regardless of whether they come from a Republican background or a Democratic background or no party preference background. It's not a secret. Look, there are a lot more Democrats than there are Republicans in this state. And that's why my campaign is really focused not on partisanship, not on ideology. I think for too long in our state, in our politics, we've been focused on partisanship, on right and left. And if you think about a job like controller, this is the chief fiscal watchdog of our state, the person who's supposed to give us accountability for every dollar we spend. That's not a Republican or Democrat job description. It's we need someone up there who can be competent, who can be independent. And that's what I'm going to be focused on. So, you know, it is absolutely true that Republicans have had a very tough time winning in California. Independents have had a tough time winning in California, too. But at some point, people in the state are going to stand up and say, you know what, we want to put competence over partisanship. We want to put independence over ideology. And I believe that I have the candidacy and the message and the things I want to do in office that are going to make that possible. And that's why we're enthusiastic about this campaign and about the prospects ahead.
All right. So there were some revelations post-primary about you. And prior to that, you were asked, every Republican in the state of California is asked, did you vote for Donald Trump in the previous elections? You had declined to say if you did. And then once the primary was over, I believe in CalMatters, you said you did not vote for the former president. Why wait till after the primary? Why just not nip that and say, I didn't vote for him. Thank you. Next question.
Well, you know, I think it's been pretty clear from day one. If you look at my record and my background, I am an independent-minded Republican. You know, I worked for Mitt Romney when he served as a presidential candidate. I am somebody who does not have a record of being all that close to the former president. And the reality is that as time has gone on, the former president remains in the news. You know, and these revelations around the January 6th investigations, they're stomach churning to me. It's an abomination what happened that day. And it's clear that, you know, he is still very much a part of our politics and very much in the public discussion. And so I just wanted it to be absolutely clear to people. I did not support him in 2016. I did not support him in 2020. And I would probably support someone else in 2024. And those are things that I felt like I wanted to say, given the fact that this continues to be a factor in our politics. You know, I'm focused every single day on California and on what we can do to bring, as I said, greater transparency and accountability to the state, the fiscal situation in the state. And I really am entirely focused on that. And those are the things I like to talk about on a day-to-day basis.
All right, let's talk about your opponent, Malia Cohen. We had her on the show last week. I asked her about a bit of an exchange that you guys had on Twitter, and this was her reaction to your candidacy. I'm going to paraphrase just in the spirit of keeping things within the time constraints of our discussion here. She basically said, you have no record, your political beliefs and your ideology are out of step with Californians. What is your response to that?
You know, we've had a little bit too much of the typical politician who just does these sort of drive-by attacks based on partisanship. You know, I think it's important to understand my background. I'm one of the few people that's been appointed by both a Democratic and Republican president to serve in senior positions in government. Barack Obama appointed me to serve on the Social Security Advisory Board, trying to fix and save Social Security. George W. Bush appointed me to try and get healthcare costs down. So I'm somebody who has not been strictly partisan on one side of the aisle. I have worked on how we solve problems. That's really been the focus of my career and life. And I've worked with Democrats, I've worked with independents over the years. So the notion that I'm some kind of one-party partisan warrior simply doesn't square with the facts. You know, unfortunately, Malia Cohen has been a partisan warrior in her life and her career. She's someone who, in fact, in interviews has said that she would actually share audit results with her friends who are Democrats before issuing to them to the public. That's not really what I think a controller needs to do. I think a controller needs to be focused on being a representative and an advocate for taxpayers first. And that would be my focus, not on protecting party or on protecting particular people in state government who happen to be my friends. It's about how do we protect taxpayers first and how do we actually solve problems in the state? And that's going to be my focus if I'm elected controller.
Lonnie Chen, Republican candidate for California controller. We appreciate your time here on Inside California Politics.
Thanks, Nikki.